Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the third video of the day. In today's third video, we are going to be predicting the MLS playoffs. The MLS wildcard round gets underway tonight. We're going to talk about those games both in the East and the West. We'll break them down. We'll also go ahead and talk about, of course, the best of three round one games as well. We'll go ahead and give our predictions for the full MLS Cup, who I think is going to be playing in the Audi MLS Cup for the 2024 season on December 7th. And more in today's video. However, if you guys are new to the channel, you already know what to do. Leave a like, subscribe, turn that bell on. We do our best to post on this day, on this channel, every single day. Coming up next is going to be our NFL reactions. That will be the final video of the day. Tomorrow, probably three or four videos again, just because we got to get content out for you guys. We've been missing a lot of stuff, so we got to cover a lot. We got to talk about the World Series. Obviously, our reactions and predictions, and of course, NFL predictions as well. So, without further ado, let's hop in to these MLS 2024 predictions for the MLS playoffs. All right, starting off with the wild card in the East, you got Portland, I believe. Give me just a second here. Going into the Whitecaps, I've never heard of that team in my entire life. That's why I kind of had to zoom in there. I'm going to go with Portland here to upset the Whitecaps. I've just never heard of that team. I know Portland does have a couple of really good players on that roster, and I think that they should be able to get the job done on the road in the wild card round. Now, keep in mind, it's one game. Win or go home. If you win, you're in. If you lose, you go home. So this, obviously, for the Whitecaps is going to be at their place. I don't know where they are. I don't know how Portland's going to deal with all that travel. I'm going to stick with my decision and go with Portland just because I know a little bit more about Portland than I do the Whitecaps, of course. So, that's my prediction for the West. Let's talk about the East wildcard, where you have Montreal hosting Atlanta United. Atlanta United, the roster has completely changed from the start of the season. This is going to be a fun matchup. This really is. I like Atlanta United. If you saw the speech in the pregame locker or in the postgame locker room once they clinched the wild card. By the way, at the start of the day on Saturday, they had a 2% chance of getting in. They needed two of three things to happen. It happened, and Atlanta United is in the playoffs. So we don't need to let up. We got to get the balls to our playmakers. Obviously, there's no Almada. There's no Martinez anymore as well. The Guzan's got to play a really solid game goalkeeping-wise. I think he does. I think that Atlanta United actually goes on the road and upsets Montreal and moves on to the wild card round as well. And let's go ahead and talk about the round one matchups in this MLS playoffs. All right, we're going to go down, just predict the whole thing, then we'll talk about it. We're going to start off in the Western Conference here, though, as we make our way to the East. So, starting off in the top left, you got the 2 seed going against the 7 seed here, LA Galaxy, Colorado Rapids. I gotta go with LA Galaxy. They are by far the better team. They have a lot of superstars on that team. I think it's gonna be about for them getting the balls again to their playmakers and scoring goals. I think that they win this game, this series in 2 games, and then go on to the next round, wait a little bit, and they should be good to go, as I think LA Galaxy will move on to the next round. Now, next is Real Salt Lake, and I believe Minnesota, if I'm not mistaken, as well. Minnesota, I could see them absolutely upsetting Real Salt Lake. However, with that said, I don't think they're that vulnerable. I think Real Salt Lake's got a good shot in this series. I do. I think, again, you got to score goals if you're going to win games. That's just the bottom line there. That's what you got to do. I mean, there's no, way around that one. I know that's a basic thing to say, but that's what you do. I think Real Salt Lake has all the pieces that they need, and I think that they get the job done against Minnesota in this matchup there in the West. That sets up LA Galaxy versus Real Salt Lake for you guys who are keeping track at home there. Now, up next, I believe, is Houston going up against Seattle, the Sounders. This is going to be a really good matchup series as well. I think that Houston, again, has a real shot to upset Seattle, but I don't think they will. I like Tyler Adams, I believe, if he's still even there for Seattle. I like that Seattle's roster has a couple of United States men's national team players on it. I think that that, in and of itself, is going to allow them to get the ball, again, to their playmakers, open the box, when they're inside the box, open it up a little bit, open the scoring a little bit for them. I think that they get the job done here against Houston, and I think this series goes to 3 games as well. Now, You have LA Galaxy versus Portland. The West, I gotta go LA Galaxy here. I think this is where Portland's run will come to an end, unfortunately. I think LA Galaxy's probably gonna win it all. I do. I really do. At least make it to the finals in the Eastern side of the bracket. Spoiler warning on that one as well. However, when it comes down to it, Portland, they can win this game. They've played LAFC a lot in that or in the regular season. So I can expect them that, hey, they're going to come out and compete. I expect this one to go to three games. I really do. I think this is going to be one of the fewer ones where the one seed is going to have to play three games. But I got LAFC winning this matchup as well, which sets up us LAFC versus Seattle. Got to go with LAFC in that one. Real Salt Lake versus LA Galaxy. I could see Real Salt Lake upsetting LA Galaxy. I just don't think it's going to happen. I got to go with LA Galaxy, LAFC, LA Galaxy, in the MLS Cup Final, or Western Conference Finals, Got to go with LAFC here. Again, their offense right now is just way too good for them not to make it to the MLS Cup. I think they do, and they represent the West in that MLS Cup Championship. Next up here is the Eastern Conference. Let's go ahead and go over that one up first. And, of course, the wild card matchup. You got CF Montreal hosting Atlanta United. Man, if one more thing would have happened, we would have just upset, or we would have been hosting the wild card tonight. However, that is not the case, and they got to go on the road. I think Atlanta United actually gets the job done. The way that the coach has them fired up right now, the boys fired up. Obviously, Salah is going to be a very good, important part of that. I believe that's how you say his name, at least. On the offensive side of the ball for Atlanta United, I think that the boys are ready. I think that they win this game and upset Montreal there on the road to move on to round one as well. Now, speaking of round one, let's go ahead and get into it. You got the Crew, Columbus, going into as the 2 seed, hosting New York. I don't know why they have that there at the MLS Cup bracket, but hey, it is what it is. I gotta go with Columbus Crew here. I know it's basic, but New York has not been playing great. The one game that I went to this year where I saw Atlanta United and New York Red Bulls, their defense looks like they could get stopped easily. I think they do. I think Columbus wins this one in two games as well, as they will move on to the next round there. FC Cincinnati, New York City FC. Gotta go with FC Cincy. The boys have been cooking over there at FC Cincy right now. Obviously, they're going to be one of the favorites to win the MLS Cup every single year. They just added Robinson to that. It's an entirely God squad of a team. I think they get hot at the right time. They can most definitely make a run. And I think it starts now in this wild card matchup, as FC Cincinnati will get the job done there as the 3 seed. Orlando City going into hosting Charlotte, gotta go with Orlando City. I think that Orlando City is pissed that they lost that game on Saturday. I really am. I think that if they would have won, that would have been the 3 seed. I believe that's kind of how that would have played out on Saturday. Don't quote me on that one yet. But I think Orlando City's pissed. They're coming off a loss to Atlanta United, which honestly should have been a draw. That got called back through VAR, which thank God VAR exists. Otherwise, Atlanta United wouldn't be in the playoffs right now. But I think Orlando City's got the better playmakers. I don't think Charlotte is experienced enough to make the playoffs yet. And I think, or to go deep in the playoffs yet, And I think Orlando City is going to get the job done as the 4 seed and 3 games. Now, of course, you have everybody's favorite team, Inter Miami, right now, hosting Atlanta United, if all things stand correctly. Gotta go with Inter here. Messi, Suarez, I mean, that's all you can ask for. They're the two top-scoring teams, or goals-scoring players in the league right now, and they're going to get the job done against Atlanta United for sure in that matchup. So, that sets up Inter versus Orlando, where I gotta go with Inter there in that semifinal. Then FC Cincy versus Crew, and I gotta go with FC Cincy. I really do. I think FC Cincy is going to upset Columbus Crew. I think with the addition of Robinson to that team, adds a little bit of extra juice and adds a little bit of roster depth, if you're asking me as well, which is why I gotta go with FC Cincy here, as they will upset Columbus Crew in that round as well, which brings us to the Eastern Conference Final. You have Columbus Crew, or you have FC Cincinnati versus Inter Miami. This one's going to go to 3. Obviously, it's going to be a fun time. I got Messi and Miami in this matchup as they will be in the MLS Cup Finals. And then, of course, you have the final. The MLS Cup Final comes down to one game. Inter Miami versus, of course, the Western Conference representative, which is going to be LAFC. Here's the script for you guys. LAFC goes up 2-0 at halftime. Messi and Inter Miami come out of the locker room. They're ready to go. Fired up. Messi with an early 50 minute goal in the second half. Messi, Suarez, that sort of thing happens right there. Then they get a penalty kick in which Messi sends them to extra time. Then in extra time, it is a 3-3 game. I don't think it goes to penalty shootouts. I think Messi at the buzzer gets a really good goal for Inter somehow, some way. And I think Inter Miami obviously gets the job done and wins the MLS Cup with Messi and Suarez. Kind of like the Los Angeles Rams in the NFL where they have just bought that team. That's the script for me. Let me know what you think about it in the comments down below. Do not forget to like this video, subscribe, turn that bell on as we do our best to post all this shit on every single day. With that being said, I'm going to hop off and end so you guys can watch it on time. Have a great rest of your day if I don't see you in the NFL reactions. And as always, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.